So yeah, I'll be starting now. I won't be wasting time for anyone. Yes, I'm really glad that you could make it to be here. As you know, my name is Supraja and I'm one of the IEEE Extreme Ambassadors on behalf of IEEE Hyderabad section. And if you haven't heard about the IEEE Extreme Programming Competition before, it is just one of the world's largest programming competitions organized directly by IEEE over 70 countries. So thank you for joining today. We'll be discussing about IEEE Extreme in detailed manner. So I'll just start the slideshow. Yeah. So we'll be speaking about IEEE Extreme Ambassador Program and then the registrations and few other things. And am I audible?
Yes, you're clear.
Okay, fine. I would need insights from you because I'm not watching that MS Teams window right now. So I'll be needing your feedback too. Then I'll start in 2 minutes and we'll be talking about IEEE Extreme Ambassador Program and then registrations and how to register yourself and what are the prerequisites. And you can ask your doubts at the end of the session. So let's get started. What exactly is IEEE Extreme? IEEE Extreme is one of the premier programming competitions exclusively for IEEE student members. And it could be graduate student members or else our current student members. Only prerequisite is that you must have active IEEE student membership. That's it. And it is open for all undergraduate and graduate students with active IEEE student membership, we could say. And it is hosted virtually and simultaneously across the world. We can either have it in college if time permits, or else at some proctored venue. So participants are basically proctored, I mean, invigilated by one IEEE professional member who is usually our student branch counselor. And then while registering for competition, it is mandatory to have a proctor with you. I mean, I'll give you Marthis's membership ID to you. While you register, you just enter that number and sir will receive a mail and sir will accept or confirm as your proctor. We host many events in IEEE and many other competitions, hackathons run all over the world. But what makes IEEE Extreme unique? IEEE Extreme is one of the largest competitive programming events in the world. Last year, more than 9,000 participants took part in it. And it is always welcoming and it always aims for an international community. I mean, regardless of your college, student branch, university affiliation, level of expertise, whether you are an expert in coding or else a beginner, nothing is considered. You must have one IEEE active student membership. That's all. And
sorry for the disturbance. The slide was stuck. That second slide.
This one?
You're able to see only second slide agenda.
Oh, wait a second. I'll share it back. Can you see the fourth slide right now?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. It must be some network issue or something like that. Okay. I'll just put it in this way. Yeah. So as I told you, it is one of the largest competitive programs and all. And apart from that, I'll be explaining you about the competition day. During the competition day, we will have, which will start at 12 a.m. UTC, which is 5:30 a.m. in India. It will we'll be starting our competition at 5:30 a.m. on 23rd October, and the platform is CS Academy. I'll give all the details about it I'll give the further details in coming slides. And I'll also talk about the format of the competition and the team and the team members and the rules to be followed. And on the competition day, it will be starting at 5:30 a.m. We will be given the first set of challenge. We will receive a welcome message and first set of challenge on the CS Academy platform. Likewise, we wrote TCS exam and all. We had different platform, right? We will be having similarly this CS Academy in some browser or something else. And I shouldn't be telling you this, but you have a luxury of searching the code in Google too. But you have to write it back without any plagiarism or directly copying it as such. And if it is about teams, you can have three members, either two. Wait, I have a different slide for teams and we'll be discussing about that. And when I say it is 24 hours programming contest, I didn't mean that we will be continuously sitting before the laptop or the PC for 24 hours on stretch. We'll be given enough time to rest, eat or do some fun activities. We will plan such. And coming to the next slide, I'll explain the format of the competition. As I told you, it is 24 hours competition. I mean, 23rd October, 5:30 a.m. to next 5:30 a.m. on 24th October. Competition supports more than 25 programming languages, and you can choose whatever language you are comfortable with. Every hour, one or two questions will be added. Challenges will be added. There is no limit, time limit for each question or nothing like you have to do it in this time itself. And there is no penalty for number of submissions done also. You can submit at your convenient time, but you have to keep checking. First come, first serve basis might be taken into consideration. So, and for every correct answer, 30 points will be awarded. For every correct code you submit, 30 points will be awarded, and 70 extra points will be awarded depending on the task. I mean, if a code is so difficult and not many teams manage it to do it, submit it, we might get some extra points based on difficulty. And if a code is so easy, everyone did it, these extra points will be less. And if you want to know more about this rules of marking scheme and all, you can always visit IEEExtreme.org/rules. I gave that link down there. Are you following? Am I too fast or something?
No, Supraja, go ahead.
Okay, fine. Thank you. Like I said before, this extra 70 points will be given based on the difficulty. Next thing, this was the last IEEExtreme 14.0 winners. One from Jordan, Brazil, and Australia. And then quick history we could see. I mean, number of participants and teams are growing year by year. And this time they are aiming to achieve more people from our Hyderabad section itself. So we are putting efforts towards it. And I hope you all will participate no matter what. Eligibility. Talking about eligibility, for every student, only one thing is mandatory. We should be having either student level membership or else graduate level membership. We all have student level membership already, so we need not to worry about that. And graduate level, in the sense we have mentors and the seniors who passed out. If they have graduate level membership, they can also participate, and you can form teams with them too. There is no restriction for as such, and students who are participating, I mean, who register, they must register as a team of three members. I'll explain how a team must be in next slide. And there is no restriction like only IT, computer science, or ECE, or triple people must participate. From any domain, any discipline, people can participate. All they must have is one thing, IEEE membership, that's all. And proctors, instance, they must have senior, regular, or life member, membership grade, which is probably our student branch counselor or any student, faculty advisor. And then they need not to be from same department or same school, same college, but the participants who are taking part of this program, coding program, the participants who form a team must be from same college, same student branch. Ambassadors, every year for IEEE Extreme, one ambassador is chosen to create awareness and to create awareness about this IEEE Extreme. And this time I have been fortunate enough to become that one ambassador from our student branch. And there is no registration fee for this IEEE Extreme, and all IEEE student members can register for this IEEE Extreme programming competition. And coming to the team composition, here is where you need to be conscious. Maximum of 3 student members, or else 2 graduate student members, or 1 student member, or else 2 student members, or 1 graduate student member. I mean, maximum, you cannot choose 3 graduate student members in a team. There must be at least 1 student member, graduate student members in the sense the passed outs. Hope you understand this. Am I clear?
Yes, clear.
Okay. Then maximum only 2 graduate students are allowed. We won't be having graduate students at most, I guess, because we will all be student members itself. So 3 of us will be registering as 1 team. You have to pick your teammates and all, just like I picked mine. I'll show you how to register and registration process too. And then teams must be comprised of members from same student branch. Like I mentioned before, the teams who are going to participate in this must be from same student branch. I mean, our student branch. Just search for your teammates and make sure you make teams. By tonight, we will be making teams and registering for IEEE Extreme. And for each team, 1 proctor must be mandatory. Proctor will usually be Maruti sir, and 1 proctor can host 20 teams at maximum 20 teams. 20 into 3, it would be 60. So the other teams, if they participate, if teams are more than 60, we will look for alternate option. For now, for first 20 teams will registered will be proctored by Maruti sir. And then one more thing is, proctor won't be assisting you. I mean, proctor won't be helping you in coding or any challenges. Team members must solve and complete the problems by yourself. And this is one of the important rule to be noted. Give your attention to this. In order to rank in the competition, all teams must have a proctor in confirmed status, which means when you while registering, you will be selecting your proctor. I mean, you will enter Maruti sir's membership number in the registration form. By that, Maruti sir will be receiving a mail. And after receiving that mail, Maruti sir will either, he has an option to either confirm or decline or put it aside. I mean, put it in unconfirmed status. Unless Maruti sir's confirmation, we don't have Maruti sir's confirmation, then we are not eligible for participation certificates or prizes. So make sure that Maruti sir accept your accept your request that you chose him as a proctor. I hope you are getting the point. While registering, you'll be putting Maruti sir's membership ID so that sir will receive a mail, and sir must accept that request as acting as your proctor, a proctor for your team. And unless sir accepts that, we won't be eligible for participation certificates. Additionally, we will be able to participate, but we won't get any participation certificate, and we won't be in ranking. I mean, they will be giving ranks for us, and we won't be recognized that we participated in that. And impact of IEEE Extreme. What do we get if we participate in IEEE Extreme? As a student, we will improve our networking skills with global programming community. And moreover, this participation certificate of IEEE Extreme is so much valuable. it will fetch you jobs easily, and we will build our personal confidence in relation to personal coding skills. Nevertheless, we will know, I mean, we will get a feedback on what skills are strong and what skills we need to develop. And prestigious bragging, prestige and bragging rights are obvious. We'll be telling people that we have participated in so and so programming contest, which is so prestigious and all. That's up to you. And then what proctors get is they get opportunity to mentor students. I mean, they get an idea of original programming challenges. And also, our student branch gets a name and fame. And moreover, what ambassadors get is that, third years, listen to this. One among you can be ambassador from our student branch next year. So you can apply for, after this IEEE Extreme Coding Contest, they will be asking for IEEE Ambassador Program, I mean, next 16.2, for which you can all apply. I'll let you know the details later after this, after IEEE Extreme 15.0. Wait a second. After I finish this, I'll be talking to you again. And then we'll be being an ambassador actually improves your network with other students, like student activities committee in Hyderabad section or any other level. You will be getting your network will grow. I mean, it's your good chance to give back to the communities, and you'll be knowing about IEEE volunteer structures on a deeper level. And if it is about prizes, they are mind blowing, man. First place is that we'll be getting $3,500 for each team member, and free travel and accommodations to your choice of any conference, IEEE conference, anywhere in the world. And second place is that $400 cash award, third is $300, and fourth to 100th place, we might get a chance to hit it. I mean, fourth to 100th place, we will get a gift bundle and top coder t-shirt for each team member. And practice community, as I say, you can find old problem statements. I mean, old question papers and old questions on this csacademy.com/IEEExtreme-practice. I'll give this PPT again. I'll post this PPT in the group, and later on, why this practice community started is that we started this IEEE Extreme in 2015 to assist first time extreme participants, people who are new to coding. And from then, this practice community has been serving all the freshers to give an idea about IEEE Extreme. They all hold this old questions and old patterns. You can check that. And you know, I told you before, right? CS Academy is the platform which hosts this IEEE Extreme Programming Contest. When you find time, just open that csacademy.com/IEEExtreme and then get familiarized with that platform. Don't jump directly into the competition. I would request you all to once check that platform before you do it. I mean, get aware of it. And this is an example. This was one previous question and first challenge, I suppose. It's just that a problem statement is given. Addition, you are given two integer values, A and B. Compute the output, output their sum. Compute and output their sum. Which means that it is a simple problem. We have to write a program to add two numbers. Just addition of two numbers, that's it. We can surely give it a chance, right? I mean, few questions are easy. Why to give up in before trying? I mean, why to fear the unknown? We shall register for it and we shall see. And we also have the luxury of searching the code in Google. So there is no need to worry. We will do something in that. It won't be as tough as we imagine it to be. So it's just simple program to write an addition of two numbers, two integers, that's it. And in CSA platform, you could start solving basic problems. You can open CSA platform and you can start solving basic problems so that you get familiarized with that platform. And you can search for IEEE Extreme rules, document and platform for libraries and functions available. And you can search what libraries and functions available in that. And one more important thing is that when you submit it, each submission will be considered as, I mean, you are given one problem. If you submit it, it will be taken as attempt to solve the challenge. So before you submit, you can use this compile or run sample inputs as an option. You can check your code by using compile or run sample inputs feature before submitting. Okay. And then public relation ambassador program, which is next be useful for third years. It is a good opportunity, make use of it. It is just to build public relations among the IEEE in every corner of the world. It's just to international efforts to improve the network of IEEE team. And what PR ambassadors, I mean public relation ambassadors do is that they just host seminars and bring awareness about IEEE Extreme, like I am doing right now. Last year, 987 PR volunteers are selected, one student member per each student branch. Like this year, I have been that ambassador, like I told you before. And then you can see the growth of PR ambassadors and volunteers year by year. Number of student branches have also been growing. And these are just statistics, not so important and all. So how our student branch can support? We will be hosting this IEEE Extreme 15.0 in our student branch, and we will be posting this all on Facebook or in Instagram, and we will tag that IEEE Extreme as proof that we hosted this program in our student branch, so that we our student branch gets recognized globally. And this is the old gallery of IEEE Extreme. I mean, teammates sat and they are participating in that. You could see this gallery, and that's all, I guess. These are the sponsors: IEEE, Das Keyboard, Syncfusion, and like I said, this is the CS Academy is the platform partner. Outreach partner is about Women in Engineering. And remember these important dates. You have to register before 16th October 2021, and competition date is 23rd October 2021. I'm sorry, but you have to wake up at 5:30 a.m. 12 a.m. I mean 0 hours UTC, Universal Time Coordinated, is just that. We are five and a half hours ahead that GMT, so we will our competition starts at 5:30 a.m. It's better than them, right? For them, it starts at midnight, but for us, it starts at early in the morning, 5:30. And results will be announced after 4 to 5 weeks after the competition commences. And if you have any doubts, and if you are curious to know more about this, you can reach to IEEE Extreme team, IEEE Extreme at IEEE.org or IEEE Extreme.org, or you can just follow the Facebook page. And if you have any doubts, you are free to reach me out. And this is my mail, and this is my WhatsApp number. You would be probably having this. And before last thing, I'll be showing you how to register. Stay back. I'll show you how to register. I'm clear until now, right? Do you have any doubts? Meanwhile, you can ask your doubts until I open that page. Do you have any doubts?
Yes, Supriya, the thing is like we have to be in front of laptops for whole day.
No, that's what I said, right? You will be having breaks and all. You can open. It's not like, I don't think it must be done on laptop, or else even phones can do the job. Even phones have this Chrome, right? Google Chrome. If you are comfortable, I mean, you don't have laptops and all, you can do it in Google Chrome too. Get it?
Yeah.
Give me a second. I'll be sharing how to. Yeah. Do you see the screen?
Yes.
Oh, all I did is I have searched it in Google, IEEE Extreme 15.0, and the first hello, is there any issue with screen share and all? Am I audible?
Yeah.
Is there any issue with screen share or else it is loading and all?
No, it's clear, I think so.
Okay. Now, after opening this IEEE Extreme.org, you will be finding this register now. Do you find it? I mean, can you see it?
Yes.
We just have to click on this. And after that, he will ask us to sign in. Yeah. At this corner, we have to sign in. Can someone say their email address and password, or else I have to do mine itself, because I finished my registration. That's why I don't want to do right now.
If we already done our registration, can we add members to our Teams later?
Yeah, you can add later. Okay, did you register yourself already?
No, I didn't having Proctor's ID, so I stopped.
Proctor's ID, I'll be sending Marthister's ID soon. Give me your email address. Why don't we do it right now?
Yeah, carry on.
Give me your email address. Meghana?
DEVIL256.
Am I right?
Yeah.
Text your password to me in WhatsApp. People, are you watching? Juniors?
Yes.
Okay. Do you understand what I have been talking? Hello, juniors. I need your response here. I don't know if it is working at all. So. After you sign in, you will find Teams and Proctor registration, two such options. You are not a Proctor, you are a team member, so you will be clicking on Teams. So this is hers. I mean, you have to decide a team name. What should I name your team, Meghana? Can I name it?
Beginner.
Huh?
Beginner.
I mean,
name it as beginner.
Beginner. Actually, I named my team as Shreyas STB7. So
then go with the similar kind of name.
No problem. Your wish. Team name is completely up to you. People find this after signing in. You'll automatically find our college name and code here. You know, need not to fill anything. Already everything will be filled out. And after you sign in, your name, your membership number will be automatically filled. And experience, leave it blank because we don't have experience in participating IEEE Extreme before. So leave it blank. And here you can add member. For example, okay, before adding member, I'll let you know this. Proctor number, right? Our Maruti Suzuki's proctor number is this. 9493281 0. I'll put it in chat box too. I mean, later on, I'll give it to you. And you just have to submit it. Before you submit, add your
click on team number.
Sorry?
Click on I wish to receive communications box too.
Okay. You wish to receive. Those are just ads, dear. Nothing to do with that. One hell of emails. That's it. And yeah. We'll be adding a member. For example, I'll just choose as a volunteer, I'll just be choosing Srijas, I mean our student branch chairs. Just for example, I'll remove her again, no problem, but I'll just add her. This is her membership ID. And even here, her experience is nil, so I kept it as blank, save, and automatically her details will be given. See, validation is done, and you can find as member too. Here, get to Srija Reddy and all, her email address is here. Similarly, if you want to change this team member, you can just remove this team member and add again. Okay, you can just click submit, and you will receive a notification that a team has been successfully submitted, and you will all the team members, including Proctor, will receive the email that your team is submitted. I mean, successfully submitted. That's it. Got it? If you have any doubts now, you can ask. People? No doubts at all? Akash, Stravya, Chaitanya? If you don't have any doubts, you could just say no doubts at all. So I'll assume you didn't hear anything at all if you don't respond. So that's all, I guess. I'll terminate the meeting here. Thank you for joining. And reach out to your friends and explain what the process is. I mean, you can explain them. I guess you got all your doubts cleared, so I'll be ending the meeting. Thank you.